Hello. Hello.
We'll be right back.
Advance Auto Parts knows what makes a car guy a car guy. It's the commitment to maintain an engine through the 300,000-mile mark. It's burning the midnight oil to finish a job most guys would rather hand off. It's loyalty. And it's why there's speed perks from Advance Auto Parts. Spend $100 and get $20 off your next qualified purchase. No cards, no points, no nonsense. Advance Auto Parts, for guys who love getting under the hood.
See store to sign up or visit speedperks.com for details.
We'll be right back. All right, welcome back to Championship Sunday. We are ready to get this show on the road. I got Rival back with me today. Toy Soldier was supposed to be here. I don't know where he's at, but Rival's going to step in again. So we're actually really excited for this one. We had to stop this mid-match yesterday, but we're going to get this started again for you. We are going to be doing Uplink. This is actually map 4. So somebody's going home for this match, Rival. So let's get this show on the road, guys, and enjoy the show. Take us out, Rival.
So we are going to be on Detroit Uplink. Yesterday we saw a good show from both teams. You saw that 5-1 comeback coming from Zentral. True Gaming, they really need to step it up on this one. They can't let any mistakes happen like they did in that search. Zentral, I don't know, man. They both have good slaying power. You're going to see a lot of kills usually from Yigidiom and the other players on that team. Oh, we have to end the game.
We got somebody that
it's a draw. RTB and await further orders.
Arden, what are you doing? Are you lubing up? What are you doing? That's stuff you put for like football?
All right, so it is going to be Detroit Hardpoint, actually, not Uplink. We did have a problem getting into this game. So you're going to see some kills coming from Oog and also a lot coming from Yomp. As I said before, they're pretty heavy in the slaying department for their teams. Alright, so everyone is spawning in. Dynasty, we can start with Dynasty. Because Dynasty, he was dropping numbers yesterday at the beginning of the day, but like, he just dropped off for some reason midway through like the end of the day for his last matches. I don't know what happened there. But good slaying power coming from this True Gaming team. They need to keep their composure, but you see two picks coming from them easy in the beginning. That's three, so they should have full hook control for a while. He does see one, but he does get picked off from the side. They are pushing from garage, and then you're going to see Zentral take control of this hill. Harpo does pick one off on top Atlas, but does get picked off from garage window. Raze is going to be trying to push from hospital to get that nice peek through the hospital window. He does see one get the pick, and he does get naded off. So we are going to be going on with Atomics. Atomics is going to be just spawning up. He's going to be pushing the mid street to that hill. He got the assist, but he does die off. You got some team killing. I don't know what that was from Hitman. He is just going to be sitting in the hill, trying to hold this down for his team. Get a little bit of a lead here. in the last 2 seconds of the hill, but as I said, there is only 2 seconds, so they are going to be rotating to the next hill. You see Yomp trying to hold down the back alley slash door area and just hold those spawns for his team. He should really have an AR back there. I don't really know why he was just running a sub trying to hold that down. There's only one person on the hill, but he is going to be able to hold it down, Shane. He's a really nice slayer for this team. Zentinel is down in points. Shane is just doing a nice job slaying and holding down the hill by himself. He's not really seeing any action in the hill. Actually, he does die off, so we are going to be going on board with Dynasty. He's going to be pushing in front of the hill with that AR. He isn't able to get anything. Hugh is spawning up now. He is also the bow runner for his team. He gets one pick, but he does die off. So Harpo is also doing the same thing. ARs usually hold down the area of this map. 5 seconds left on the hill. You should have saw people rotate. You have a few people already rotated. Harpo is trying to get that kill mid-street, but he does get picked off. So he sees two, but he probably made that call out for the two that went mid. True Gaming is going to hop in this hill and try and catch up in points a little bit. But Zentinel does have control of the hill. Actually, no, True Gaming does have control of the hill. They are going to try and take away with the lead a little bit. He sees one on Garage Head Glitch, but he does get picked off. Yomp just got a double kill. He is getting a little bit hyped right now. Yomp is just trying to hold down the middle of the map. He doesn't see anyone, so he backs off. The hill is contested. They are pushing the hill, but I don't think they're going to get any control because this True Gaming team is just completely slaying them out. It's actually pretty easy for them to get these picks. Actually, as I say, that he does get picked off that ambulance head glitch. Shane is going to try and rotate and keep people off that rotation from the enemy team, but he does get picked off, so Dynasty is going to be the one pushing into that hill for his team. He does get the one pick off. He's going to be waiting for other players. They do get the successful rotate. There is one in window, but they don't see anything. He is trying to just hold down this hill, try and peek that window. He does have a bow, though, so he is going to lose that gunfight to the SMGs that rush that hill. Not sure why they have bowels rushing the hill. It's a pretty stupid thing to do, in my opinion, just rush bowels. But you should have your bowels just holding down the spawns and outside of the hills, and you should have one or two, or two or three, actually, SMGs just rushing the hill and trying to get that scrap point for your team. But True Gaming does take control of the hill. Infinite does pick up that nice two-piece. They are trying to just hold down this hill, and it's a pretty close game here. Nothing really too crazy yet, but no one's really taken off, and it's not a blowout. It's pretty neck and neck. Yomp is still holding down that hill, but you are going to see some rotations into Walker. The rotations are just better from the True Gaming team. I don't know why they just keep getting these picks off, getting the nice rotations, getting that early time in the hill. But it is not like it's not too hard for Zentinel to be pushing into this hill and getting that time. They do have control of the hill, and they are about to hit 100 points. It is contested, though. They do get picked off, so True Gaming does take control of this one right before they get the 100. 91-98 is your score currently. Atomics, he is going to be trying to push in that hill, but True Gaming is slaying out the hill very well. Yomp is trying to hold down mid-map with that bow. He does pick one off. He sees another and does not get the kill, but he does get the assist. So he is holding down the hill. There is 7 seconds left, so you should see people rotating to the next hill. True Gaming already has people rotated, and Yomp is just holding down mid lane, completely just running through people and slaying in the slaying department. He sees one in hill, and he's still going. He is on a 6-kill streak right now, but he does get taken out.
Man, they really need this win too, because they're True Gaming's down by one. So, you know, the fact that they're stepping up right now, they really need this map, because this is going to take us to map 5, and loser is going home. So, you know, I'm really impressed with the way True Gaming is playing right now. It's pretty impressive, man, especially Dynasty 20 and 21. But 24-19 from Yomp, man. Yomp's really pulling through with slays for his team. Infinite Rays, 23-19. And then SNK, 27-23. So there's still 4 minutes left on the clock. And look what just happened. Atlas just pulled ahead. So it's going to be back and forth with these two teams. There's no doubt about it.
As you said, if True Gaming does lose this, they do go home. But if Zentinel loses, they will. If Sentinel wins, they'll move on. But if True Gaming wins, it will go to Game 5, and we will see that happen. And whoever loses that will go home. But Atomix is trying to push this hill. He does get one. He almost gets a second, but does not quite get it. Hitman is trying to push through side door. He does miss his shot, and Yomp is just holding down the hill. He almost has a 30 bomb already. 8 cashers. So he is doing work for his team. I told you before the game started, I told you this kid, he can really kill, and he is holding down these hills for his team as well. So he's just being a complete monster in this game. Oob does go down in the front of the hill. It is contested, 58 to 144. Harpo is just going to be holding these spawns. That's a nice head glitch that he is using to try and keep these spawns for his team. He does see one, but misses shots and isn't going to be able to pick that up. He's just waiting for the push, and he may die here, actually, and he does go down. So spawns will flip. Raze does see one ramp, and he does pick him off. He sees another, gets the double kill. He sees another, but he couldn't get the third. Hitman is also trying to get those double picks onto ramp. Yomp is trying to push him currently. He does get picked off. Dynasty gets one pick. Shane is trying to push him from the side. They make it this break. They do get the break, so True Gaming does take control of the hill.
They
really need to get the rest of this time in the hill to try and, you know, catch up a little bit. You may see some rotations in about 5 seconds to the next hill. Shane is just trying to milk the rest of this time for his team, so it's about a 20 score deficit. No one's really rotating for True Gaming. Not sure why. Shane should be really the only one trying to milk the rest of that hill. Now, Zentinel does have full control of this hill. It's going to be a tough break for them. Actually, they do get picked off, so they do get control of this hill. He does team kill, so True Gaming actually still has control of this hill. Zentinel is going to be trying to break this hill for them.
Wow, that was us. Honestly, that was, I'm going to straight up say, that was ballsy by True Gaming, because literally the whole team was over there getting that scrap time on the previous hill, and literally they risked letting them have it for the additional seconds, and then went over and actually contested and got it. And now look at the scoreboard. So it was ballsy, but it actually worked for them. So, you know, hey, sometimes you gotta take risks, I guess. But it actually ended up working in their favor, because now they're actually ahead 200-94. So that it worked.
Yeah, you said it perfectly. Yomp actually, he last hill, last rotation of this particular hill, he actually went off and he completely held that down by himself. But you are going to see Zentinel get those nice picks and just hold this hill down. It is contested. True Gaming is trying to hold this down, but it is contested still. True Gaming is going to take away with it. Harpo did get some really nice picks. True Gaming did take it away. Raze is trying to just hold down that hill with his SMG. He did get the pick, so there is another one. He's going to be... Oh, he does get the third, and he does get taken out. So, Zentinel, I don't think that they can come back at this point. The game is over. There is some trash talking going on. Yomp, he did go off for his team there in that game. He did drop the 40. Raze also almost dropped the 40. 221 to 208 was your final score.
Oh my God, is this team hyped right now? True Gaming is so pumped up. They are just going off, man, and it deserves to be recognized. They just tied the series 2-2. What an unbelievable match. They took some risks. It worked out in their favor, and we are going to map 5. Damn. What a match, man. What a match. Let's get this next one set up for you. Who do you think's even going to win this? This is nuts.
Map 5 S&D. So it is going to be close, but I do think True Gaming does have this S&D advantage. A lot of their players do enjoy to play S&D pretty frequently. They're amazing S&D players. We saw it yesterday. But they did came back on, so I don't really understand that. I think it was just like team mistakes that that Zentinel capitalized on. So we are going to be going on to map 5. It is going to be what map?
Biolab
S&D. This is one of my personal favorites. You see a lot of action over at A-Bomb a lot. Also, you're going to see a lot of plays from Yomp. Yomp is a key player for their team, in my opinion, especially in S&D. We do have a couple players in caster mode. I'm not sure what's really going on here. Yeah, so we are going to be starting this on Biolab S&D. Dustin, what do you think is going to happen in this match?
Well, we had a very interesting S&D match yesterday. We had Xanathil was actually accused of cheating yesterday. So we actually had to go and we ruled it that you know, there just wasn't enough evidence to say that it was cheating. So today we actually have a ref up there watching every single thing that they're doing. But I don't think it's going to be an issue today. But this is the second time that they've played S&D. So, you know, to see both teams play S&D again after what happened yesterday, it's going to be it's definitely going to be entertaining. So we'll see how this goes.
So we are going to be starting off with Yomp. He was the MVP of the team last game, holding down his hills nicely. So we are going to be able to see what he can do in this S&D matchup. He is just going to be pushing mid-circle. Actually, no, he's going to be pushing mid-alley. To try and hold down that B-bomb and just get those early picks. Still, everyone is up for each team. Yomp is just pre-aiming everything. Harpo is going to be trying to push in and push that back alley with his AR to try and get that pick off so they can get that advantage and get that bomb down. Harpo, I don't know if this is a smart play, to be honest. If he gets picked off, that's a bad place for bomb to be. He does see one on Green Cat, so he does get that pick. So it is going to be a 2v4 in favor of Zentinel. Yomp is going to be trying to make some plays here, but I do think they are rotating A, which is very smart of them. You see one mid bio and one in back spawn, so they are going to be pushing up A. I think Yomp is now realizing this. He does see that they did plant the bomb. Yomp and Shane are going to be trying to push up. Shane does get one pick. Yomp does go down, so it is going to be a 1v3, 1v2. Shane does see another 1v1. 1v1 now, so if he does clutch this 1v3, that'll be actually pretty amazing. He is peeking, so he is getting the defuse. He does not get the 1v1, so that will be 1-0 Zentinel. That was actually pretty close. He almost clutched that 1v3, and it was actually a 2v4. But Yomp did go down early on. So that was a good play by Zentinel Gaming.
I don't know. Knowing that there's one left, and, I mean, it was close to defuse that, but it wasn't, like, so close that you want to risk that. I feel like he should have just abandoned that defuse and maybe just knew that the other team member was coming at him. So, I don't know. I think that was a bad call by Yomp.
Yeah, I also agree with that. I don't think Shane should have tried to defuse that one-on-one like that. He was pretty close to the bomb site, easy checking that bomb. So, Yomp is almost going to get taken out, but he does get away. It is going to be all members up for this team. Actually, one does go down for True Gaming. Two go down for True Gaming. It is going to be a 1v3. Dynasty going to try and make some plays. You don't see too many 1v4s, so he does go down. He does go down, and the round is going to end 2-0 for Zentinel Gaming. And whoever does win this match will proceed, and whoever loses will go home. So you are going to see that 2-0 lead coming from Zentinel.
Yeah, this is not a position that True Gaming wants to be in. They worked really hard to win that last map, so, you know, to let it slip out of your fingers now is not a good thing. But, you know, we're going to jump on board with SMK, see what he can do, see where Hitman is with the bomb here. Looks like they are definitely staying together, which is extremely smart, but now they have two down, so it's actually 4v2 right now in favor of True Gaming. So looks like they're going to slow it down here and just kind of wait and see what happens. Bring up the big map here so you guys can see. Both teams playing extremely cautious because each team knows exactly how important this map is. Just playing the waiting game right now. Looks like they are going to push. All right, so they are going to push right now. Looks like they're going to try to get planted A. Oh, he does go down. It's now 4v1, and there you have it. So they are in the game now, 2-1 in favor of Zen. So I don't know, man. This could go either way. This could literally go to the last round for all we know, because these teams both seem to be on top of their game today.
Yeah, I feel like True Gaming just made some really early mistakes in the past two rounds. But they did turn it around in that round right there. So Atomics is going to be our player to watch right now. He is 2-2, no bomb plants or anything. He is just going to try and peek this A bomb, try and get that early pick off. Bomb is going to be going A, I believe. Yeah, Oog does have bomb. I really recommend trying to get a pick first before you get bombed down, so that gives you that man advantage and you could just trade off kills easier than you would with an extra man. So people are going to be flooding A once they realize no one is B. One does good. They traded, so now it is going to be a 3v3. Actually, Oog gets that nice kill on Raze, so it will be a 3v2. Oog is going to be pushing mid bio. He's going to peek white tunnel, doesn't see anything. They are going to be rotating to B to try and get this bomb down. No one really is there to contest that. Actually, there is one. He does get spotted, does get picked off, and they do trade that kill though, so it will be a 2v1. 2v1, and he may clutch this. He didn't see him to his left. So he does go down, and it will be tied 2-2.
Last round, calling it.
Yeah, True Gaming did come back in this game from that 2-0 deficit. That was some nice plays, honestly. He tried to get that nice 1v2, but he didn't quite seem to his left. Very unfortunate, but we are going to be going into this next round. Hitman is going to be our player that we are watching. I don't think he takes bomb. No. He does take bomb. Yeah. So one actually two. What? Oh. What? Okay. So one goes down, but the team kills are coming from this True Gaming team. So I'm not sure actually. So it is gonna be 3v3 now. Hitman is just trying to peek that white tunnel. They are flooding B, but there is one A. So it's gonna be hard to rotate if he is watching that mid-circle area. Hitman is still by himself. Actually, no. He is still in mid-bio with that bomb. They need to try and make a push here somewhere. I'm not really sure. Yomp is trying to watch that bomb over with that sniper rifle. It's going to be tough to push either bomb. Oog is watching that white tunnel, so they are watching from every single angle. But one is behind them. I'm not sure who that is behind them. Dynasty is also back there with his AR to trade those kills. One does go down for True Gaming. That is going to be Yomp. Harpa does pick up that nice kill. Hitman, he is going to be able to get that bomb down. There is one left for True Gaming, and he does go down. So 3-2 in favor of Zentinel. They played that really nice. They were kind of at a disadvantage, but they did get that one pick, which helped them push up the bombs easier and get that last pick. So good plays coming from them, True Gaming. They did have the early advantage, but they did get a team nade for some reason. I'm not really sure how that has to happen, but Harpo is going to be our player to watch. Actually, he is 7-3 with one plant, so he is doing work for his team. He's doing actually the best in the game right now, Harpo. Hitman is going to be trying to nade or pre-nade that mid bio, but no one's really going to be pushing. They're all going to be flooding towards A. There's two members of Zentinel on A bomb site, but it is going to be a 2v4 on that bomb site. Yomp does start to kind of realize that they are going to be going A, and he needs to help his teammates. So Oog, they do spot one firing shots at them, but I don't think a gunfight's going to happen yet. they need to really play this cautious. Actually, Hitman almost does go down. That was a nasty head glitch from whoever that was on the True Gaming team. Two go down. Atomic gets that nice double kill. That's actually going to be a 3v1. Actually, a 2v1 in favor of Zentinel. Yomp, let's see what he can do here. They are just going to be on the left side of him trying to play corners and playing it passive. He does need to get that bomb, though. So I feel like if Zentinel can just watch that bomb and play a little cautious, then they can. All right, so it is going to be a 1v1 now. Yeah, he does need to get that plant down. I don't think he's not going to get any contestion. Actually, he is. He may. Yeah, he doesn't have enough time. Yeah, actually, he is going to get the plant down. So it is going to be a 1v1 with bomb down. He is mid-circle. I don't think that was a very smart play from Raze, to be honest. He could have just peeked that bomb because there were 6 seconds left and he had to peek. He had to plant to be able to win. So obviously he would try and go for that plant over anything. He's just going to play this bomb smart, and Yomp is actually going to be just camping top green. So Raze does get that kill. Yomp could not do the 1v3. But he did almost do it with that bomb plant and that two kills. So Raze just being the better player of that situation. It is going to be 4-2 in favor of Zentinel.
Man, I'll tell you what, though. Yomp, honestly, that was such a smart play by him. He just literally brought that one person to him, Raze to him. Like, honestly, I couldn't even... can't comprehend that. Like, I wish he would have won that, because that was such a smart move. That would have been the craziest clutch ever. So I'm gonna give Yomp some props on that one. But if he would have just won that gun battle, man, they would have had that round.
Yeah, Raze is gonna be in mid bio, trying to peek White Tunnel to get that one first pick. But there is also gonna be one in mid circle. They are gonna flood him, and he does get picked off. So Oog is gonna be picking up that kill. True Gaming is going to be taking this a little passive, just trying to play for picks. They are at a man advantage right now. You see, Atomics does try and peek that, but now they know where that player is. They do get another pick. Dynasty is going to be picking that up, so it is going to be actually a 1v3 or 1v4 for Atomics to try and pull off. He does see one, does get that pick. So it is going to be 1v3 now. He does not get away. So it is going to be 4-3. Still in favor of Zentro. Nice plays coming from True Gaming, getting those first two picks and just playing it smart after that. They didn't really get aggressive, because once you really get aggressive, even if you have the man advantage, they can pick you off one by one to try and even out the score there. So pretty smart plays coming from True Gaming. We're gonna start out with Yomp, actually. Yomp, I told you at the beginning of the match that he is the S&D guy for this team. I feel like they do practice a lot of S&D. He does see one, can't get the pick though. He does see one trying to defend that A-bomb site. He did back off though, because he did realize that they had the sniper rifles. That was a pretty smart play by whoever that was on Zentinel. Yomp is just going to be playing a spawn, making sure no one flanks their team. Oog is going to be your bomb carrier. He is going to be trying to push that bomb site, but they do have full eyes on A. Actually, one person is watching the flank for B, but Hitman is going to try and push up. He sees one on a bomb. He is going to be able to pick that one up. Hitman is just going to be playing this blue building. They really need to make a play that is True Gaming, that is done. Hitman does get taken out, but Harpo also trades that kill. So it is a 3v3 right now. Oog still has this bomb. They really need to push a bomb. It doesn't matter which one. I feel like they are rotating the B currently, which is a pretty smart play. But I feel like since they haven't pushed out A, they're soon going to realize that they are going to be rotating to B. He is going to get this plant down, I should say. Actually, Raze does get that one kill. They need to stay alive. Actually, Oog does get away somehow. He's trying to turn on this kid, and he does get taken out. So it is going to be Shane in that 1v3, but he does get taken out. So your score will be 5-3. If Zentinel can win this next round. That's it for True Gaming. They are going home, and Zentinel is going to be proceeding on in the tournament. So, yeah, the series is tied 2-2. This is map 5. Hopefully we could see this game 5, or not game 5, this 5-5. No, I said if they win this next round. Okay. Yeah. So we are going to start out with Harpo. He's going to try and pre-nade a little bit. Doesn't really get anything, though. Hitman is also trying to hit those pre-nades. They're really split up right now. Hitman does have your bomb, so he is going to be pushing in the mid-bio. They are going to try to make a B-push. One person watching B-bomb, actually. So they should have this plant. There is one outside. So Harpo does get that pick, so it is going to be 3v4 in favor of Zentinel if they do win this round. However, they are going to win the seed in the tournament. Yomp is trying to make some plays on that bomb site. He does see one, doesn't get the pick. He did push out into purple. I feel like they could get this defuse right now, but no one's really trying. Yomp does get that kill, and so does Oog. So Oog is going to be able to trade that kill. So it is going to be 3v2 and still in favor of Zentinel. Almost 3v1, maybe. Actually, yeah, two. They all go down. So they do get wiped out of the tournament. Good performance from True Gaming, but it wasn't enough. Zentinel does take it, so they do proceed on in the tournament.
All right, guys, we are going to be setting up your next match here as the players shake hands and everything. Great job by both of them. We'll be right back after a short commercial break. And let's see, next up, we're probably going to be running, probably that team versus Zentinel. So don't go anywhere, guys. We'll be right back.
Trying to say that on stream is not fun.
When is it?
Who? It's actually Zen. It's actually how it's supposed to be.